Hello everyone and welcome back to Zoo Crafting! I am Zookeeper Seri and we are here today with Tate and Lily apparently really wanting to sniff things that are inside of our little storage chest down there. What are you two up to? But yes, so we're here outside of the giraffe barn! And oh my goodness, it has had so much progress! I am so excited! So today, hopefully, we will be stocking our giraffe barn totally full of all sorts of delicious acacia leaves for our wonderful, wonderful giraffes. Maybe some other things, like maybe some of the bamboo. It would actually make a lot... Lily! Girl, who's my good girl? Climbing right up to see what I'm up to, huh? But it would actually make a lot of sense to go and gather up some of the bamboo that is over by the river and bring it over here so we can use it as browsing and foraging and enrichment items for our giraffes. And I kind of want to get some like hanging feeders, which could be your enrichment items that like have acacia leaves hanging from them. The more I read about giraffes, you guys, the more I have found out that they really focus on eating primarily leaves. You'll never believe it. You'll never believe it. One of the enrichment items I read about zookeepers using in a zoo was onions. Isn't that so weird? When would a giraffe eat onions? Those are like root vegetables. So when on earth would they ever have time to like dig up an onion? They don't do that. They eat up high. They don't eat down low. That's actually one of the really cool things I learned about them. Was that a butterfly? It's a butterfly, but I only have like one jar and it's already used. And if we use this on the butterfly, we'll catch a dead butterfly. But even with a dead butterfly, we could use the butterfly's little tiny body to put it in the butterfly encyclopedia. Choices. Okay. Actually, I did catch a new butterfly, didn't I? The Red Admiral. And did that do anything? Red Admiral. Let's see. The Red Admiral. You have caught three of them. It comes out during the day. Spawns near grass blocks, gravel, podzol, and stone. Feeds on all flowers, birch wood, dark oak wood, melon, oak wood, pumpkin, spruce wood. It's fast. It has a low escape rate, which is probably why I was able to catch it. And quite a bit found in temperate Europe, Asia, and North America. The species is resident only in warmer areas, but migrates north in spring and sometimes again in autumn. I absolutely love how much information there is. It's just so cool. It's just so awesome. And we actually do have some more information. Okay, I'm going to put this away so I'm not tempted to catch butterflies and kill them. But we do have some more information about giraffes we can do some reading of in just a little bit. But I actually want to do some work inside of the barn today. And I want to get more chests put down and more acacia leaves so we can be sure to feed our giraffes. But like I was saying, a lot of you guys were pretty cool because you were mentioning like alfalfa. I always say that word wrong. Is one of the main food sources that zoos will actually use for giraffes. And that is true, you guys. That is very true. Let's go get some bamboo and we'll talk about how very true that is. But some of the reading I was doing suggest that too much of that can actually put an imbalance of protein in a giraffe's diet. This is how detailed I go when I'm trying to do research on these things. And it was highly recommended that you get as much like green leafy matter, like actual leafy matter as in leaves, into captive giraffe diets as possible. And let's just gather up the super fast growing bamboo. I love how it grows so quickly. We're able to like peck it down like this and collect it. But we don't have to worry about losing our barrier. This is like a natural growing barrier that we have to keep these safari animals in. We don't have to worry about them really escaping because it grows back so quickly that before a wandering like warthog would wander over here, it's already regrown. So we don't even have to worry about it. All right, let's come down. All this awesome bamboo. We'll collect it up and put it in for our little zoo. All right, let's gather all this up. Let's gather all that up. There we go. Good job, Lily and Tate. Good job. Watch out here. All right, I really should make like some sort of really cool balance or like jumping challenge. Oh, there's more butterflies. They know I'm out of nets. I haven't seen that one though. Even if I caught it and it died, it would be really sad, but I might need this specimen. I might. I'm just desperate because, oh gosh, there it is again. Oh, it's so pretty. Okay, I'm not going to do it. Well, I might do it. I can't lie. I might do it if it gets any closer to me. Hey you, come here. Oh, it's so pretty. I'm obsessed with those butterflies. And unfortunately, you do have to catch a few of the dead ones in order to put them in your butterfly encyclopedia and then be able to research them. But you know what? Butterflies don't live very long anyway, and I'll give them the best life I can. All right, so let's head back over to our giraffe area. This is the first enchantment planted by Ryan for Trivia Tree Challenge. Beautiful acacia tree. I hope when we have... Oh, there's another butterfly. I hope when we have some free roaming giraffes over here, they'll be able to nibble gently on its leaves. But yeah, what I was doing in terms of research for dietary concerns of a giraffe taught me that you want to avoid this grass. This grass is bad. Grass can actually sit inside of their gut for too long and make them very sick. And you want to avoid things that are too high in protein, and you want to stick to stuff that's really like leafy matter, Lily, which is why today we are going to pluck so many leaves, Lily girl. We are going to get so many acacia leaves, and we are going to try to fill them up inside of the chest in here. There we go. And so what we'll do is we'll just kind of like fill this area. This is more for like the decorative aspect of it. But just fill this area with bamboo so that we know, let's see, how are we going to do this? Maybe like so? So that, I don't know, you guys. Maybe like this to show the way the bamboo would sort of just be piled to the side, perhaps? The basic goal is to just sort of organize it inside of chest so that it would look a little bit similar to what you would hope to find if you were coming in here and trying to gather supplies for your giraffes, for like our little zookeeper area. So we're going to try to fill these chests with bamboo and with acacia leaves. And I think I want to turn this fence into, what would it look like if we turned this fence into like an acacia wood fence? Is it too much, Lily? I don't know. I kind of like it, but I kind of think it's... Oh, I know what I want to do. All right, Lily girl, watch out. I think what we're going to do is we're going to get some of this kind of acacia wood and make a fence out of it right here. I think that would be a good balance because we're already using like the little thatching over here, and we're using the thatching like on top of the roof. So I wanted to try a different kind of wood out just to designate, hey, this is the official area for official zookeepers to gather items from. Oh, this is so fun. And then we'll come out here and we will put down some acacia trees. And I'm really hoping that today is the day, my friends. We will be able to go and get our giraffes. I was picking up the bamboo as I was thinking that. Go and get our giraffes and bring them over here. So let's see. Oh, there's the acacia wood. So I could use that. I do need some more. You know what? I'm going to need some more acacias. I need more wood and I need more leaves, so let's go ahead and get this over with. Let's grow a few of these trees, and let's find some nice spots to grow them here in the yard, too. And I was also thinking I want to pick up all of these thorns and get them out of the giraffe yard. They actually do eat thorns, because as you guys remember, acacia trees are very thorny, and they actually have ant populations that will live in the acacia trees and protect the trees from being eaten. So you'll get like a whole ant colony who designates a tree as their tree, and anytime anyone tries to eat that tree, they'll swarm out and start biting whoever is trying to eat the leaves of that tree. So you can get a whole ant colony, which is kind of why I left that beehive there, to sort of represent the insects that infest a tree, that will defend their trees to the death, no less, so that hopefully nobody will eat their little acacia tree. But you get those guys up in the acacia trees, and you have thorns, so no wonder it's hard for giraffes, and they have to have those thick lips. They have those really thick lips that protect them from the thorns. And I wonder if they just ignore the ants. I wonder if they just like kind of eat the ants too, like, well, you're in my way. All right, let's gather all these up. But even though they have those thick lips that can protect them from thorns, I kind of wanted to clean all the thorns in this yard up so it wouldn't scratch like their legs or anything like that. So we're just going to collect all of these, get rid of them, and then we can use these thorns in other environments. I'm pretty sure, like these little thorn bushes, little dried bushes. What are they even officially called? They're called shrubs, little dried up shrubs that have no leaves on them. There we go. Pretty sure they could be used in another area of our zoo. Waste not, want not. Isn't that the rule, Tate? Isn't that the rule indeed? Oh, he's my good boy. You're getting a little hungry. Okay. Oh, Lily girl's getting a little hungry too. I'm afraid all I have left is zombie jerky. And it's almost night, so we'll go to sleep in just a second so we don't have to deal with the zombies. Oh, goodness. I'm so excited. We're actually going to have a little bit of progress done. I'll even pick these things up too. Well, and honestly, I'm excited just to share the adventures with you guys and our giraffes. And I really have been thinking about how I want to bring our zoo, our entire world, more to life. So getting more NPCs in here, getting more of the ambient animals. You guys had so many awesome ideas for ambient animals that could roam around. Okay, almost done. Is all the thorns? That should be all the thorns. Good. Let's grow a tree. But you guys had some great ideas for the ambient animals that could live here in our zoo. Look how pretty it is. Oh my goodness. I really hope our little giraffes are going to love this. I want to put like one. Can we put one down here? Will it grow here? Come on. It grew there and it kind of blocked that entrance, but that's okay. That's okay. All right. There we go. Can I put like another one over here? Will you grow there? It says no, I'm not going to grow there. Okay, let's try putting it right here. And then I should sleep. Okay, it's not going to grow. Oh, never mind. It grew. It grew. It sure did grow. Oh gosh, it's beautiful. All right, let's keep moving. Off to bed we go. I need to get more termite mounds. And actually, that's what I was going to talk about in just a second. All right, into bed. Into bed. Ah, there we go. All right, come here, little girl. Protect mom. Oh, you're such a good girl. She's my good, loyal Lily. I love you, Lily. You're such a little precious dog. All right. Look at those trees. Man, the giraffe area is coming together. I really love it. Let's get those thorns out of the way, though. I just really feel like those thorns might scratch the giraffe's legs, and I really don't want that. I want them to be able to roam around and have a good time. There's more thorns without having to worry about anything, especially because I want to have a lot of giraffe calves, little giraffe babies, who can live inside of this enclosure. All right, let's put all these away. Wow, we already have a whole stack of shrubs. I wonder where we're going to use these. We're going to have to figure that out. Oh, and I have some mushrooms I can put away too. All right, let's keep moving. And there's a shrub right here, so we'll pick it up. And then let's see if we can, what happens if I do this? Ooh, not bad. Like some nice grass. It's a nice color of grass. Just to sort of fill up these empty areas. Looking good, looking good. Watch out, Tate, looking good. But yeah, I want to get lots of ambient animals in, and some of you guys suggested really cool things like anteaters and pangolins and creatures that we currently don't have in Minecraft, but oh, do I ever wish we did, that could go in to drop the termite mounds. And I think that's a really cool idea. Like, pangolins would be really neat. I don't know if they are... Oh, this one's a little bit small. But that's okay, because the babies need to be able to reach those trees too, so we'll leave it. But yeah, I don't know... And can I get the shrubs just with my bare hands? Is that going to hurt me? Aw, you destroy them. I don't want to do that. But I don't know if we have... It, like, pangolins, I don't know if they're actually something you would find in the same part of Africa that you would find giraffes in. But we'll definitely do some research. And we'll definitely add more creatures into our giraffe exhibit. From what I was researching, giraffes actually do better if they have a shared exhibit. That's one of the things I meant to tell you guys last time, too. Yeah, my research... into giraffes in captivity. I will go through like a whole bunch of scientific articles and kind of brush up on it, because I promise you guys, we did not really study giraffes when I was like researching in my biology and ecology classes. Honestly, one of the things I remember studying the most when I was in my ecology class was snapping turtles. And you want to know why? Because Lily and Tate, my wonderful professor, had a passion for snapping turtles. And you'll often find in your college classes that whatever your professor kind of has an obsession with, that's what you get to learn about. And it can be really cool because then you can get caught up in their pet projects and their research. Oh, this one has another little branch. It's so cute. We should have some little like bird nest in these trees. That would be so neat. But yeah, you'll often find when you're in university that what you end up learning about is whatever your professor is really excited about at the moment. And for my ecology professor, he was extremely excited about snapping turtles. The man loved snapping turtles. So I learned a lot about snapping turtles and nothing about giraffes. So whenever I say like, I looked up this or I looked up that, that's just to remind you guys that yeah, I kind of went to school to learn about the world. Like, then there's a lot of animals in the world. There's a whole bunch of animals in the world, but I still have to do independent research because what I learned 4 or 5 years ago in my classroom has changed already with the continuing advance of science. So never be ashamed to use Google. Never be ashamed to check your sources. The most important thing you can do, Lily and Tate, no, Lily, get off that tree. You know that's a dangerous thing, my dear. Oh gosh. Give mom a heart attack. Oh gosh. And mom just used up all of the bone meal. Well, fooey. All right, I need to get more medium bone meal. But yeah, never be afraid to look stuff up, you guys. I still look stuff up. A good scientist will learn their entire lives. A good curious citizen of the world will spend your entire life learning and trying to increase that knowledge. And what we know about the world changes all of the time. It will continue to grow. So yeah, don't be shy. Don't be shy. Look stuff up today. Lily girl, you're going to give me a heart attack almost sitting on... See, Tate's at least sitting on top of the little termite mound. Can you please get off that tree? There we go. Lily, sit. All right, Tate, sit. I'm trying to grow this tree and it's not really being that helpful. Okay, you. refuse to grow tree. I'm almost out. Oh, there we go. Oh, that's a nice little zigzag pattern to it too. And then let's put another tree over here. All right, stay there, Lily. I don't want you to get hurt. Oh, look how cool that is, you guys. What a neat little tree network we have just made. Look how neat this yard is. Oh my gosh, I think, do I want to take this bush out? I kind of want to take this bush out. Let's take this bush out. Yeah, there we go. Because I kind of want more open areas for our giraffes to be able to wander. This bush can stay for now. You're safe, little bush, because I don't feel like removing you. All right. But yeah, so there's my little ramble on, like, you continue your education. No one ever, like, gets to know something, and that thing never changes forever unless maybe it's, like, the Latin language. So don't be shy. Look stuff up. I have learned so much just trying to research giraffes. Oh my gosh, what a cute tree. It's so cute. It's so cute. I love it so much. I hope the giraffes can't escape out of here on that. Okay, good. They can't. Yay! Wait, can they come over here and escape off of it? Oh gosh. Well, this could create a little bit of a problem. Oh my gosh! I just made like a giraffe escape route off the back of a tree. Well, we're gonna have to prune this tree down. This is like, just prune it back a little bit. Oh yeah, and I was supposed to be gathering leaves to feed our giraffes, wasn't I? A little whoops. All right, let's just make sure. See, this is where you have to just sort of get in here and prune things back. I just read about a baby bear, I think it was, a baby black bear, who escaped from a zoo enclosure. And the way that it was able to escape is it climbed out, and climbed out in an area that the adults never could. So it is very important to do those sorts of checks and to prune back any suspicious leaves so that we don't have escaping baby giraffes, because they can't exactly climb trees the way a black bear can, and I don't see that ending well. All right, so we have some big open spaces. We have grass, but none of the tall grass. We've removed the thorny things. I like it. Now, this is kind of tall grass, but I'm going to leave it because they sort of look like bushes, and I think those look kind of neat. This area, I could probably put a tree over here still. Not right there. I want a tree right there. Ah, and a thorn bush. There we go. We'll remove that so that we don't get any hurt little giraffelings. And let's do this. And there we go. Another beautiful acacia sapling. I love it. Wonderful, wonderful, wonderful. But yeah, basically don't be afraid to continue to look things up and learn new things, because especially in the realm of biology, things are changing every single year. That's why you guys don't have to be worried, about going out and discovering the world. There's still so much more to discover. So don't let anyone discourage you and be like, we already know everything there needs to be known about a giraffe or a panda. No, no, we don't. There's new stuff. There's new DNA stuff. There's new nutritional information. There's new ecological relationship information coming out every year. So go search, go research, go study. All right. And we have a whole bunch of acacia leaves. And a little bit of wood. I totally forgot I was supposed to be gathering up leaves, and I just ended up spending my whole time gathering up all those thorns and getting them out of the way. And then, let's see, maybe put a couple things down in the yard like this. I don't want to make it too crowded. There you go, Tate-Tate. But I do want to make it look kind of nice. We've got a whole bunch of wild herb seeds that we can have fun with too. So that'll be really cool. I need to make something really fun for Pavo out of those herb seeds, because he's the one who made them in the first place. All right, there we go. Look at this giraffe yard. This is awesome. We should probably like clean this part of it up too. So let's move the little crafting table inside. And then we'll have some room to do a bit of work over here. So the little crafting table goes there. And then if I had two little spots with chests right here, then maybe, let's see. So now this crafting table is going to be hooked up to this chest. I wonder, maybe what I should do is scoot the crafting table over like one, and then can I make like a stack? Like what if I put like the short tasseled bamboo as like a little stack? Like this is just stacks of the bamboo thatching? We'll see. We'll see. And it did hit me. We need to add in lots of cool little signs that could tell you guys about like plants. Like now we could have little information signs about like various plants you could come up to. Like the plant that I'm saying has like that infestation of ants to protect it right here. We could have a little sign you could come up and read about the relationship with that. Isn't that so cool? I'm really, 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 really excited about this little information panel addition to our zoo. It's going to make everything informative, and it's going to make it fun. And just wait till we get started on adding in like the stories again, adding in all of the characters to our different villages. It's going to be amazing. All right, so we've got the yard cleaned up, so we've removed all of the thorns so that they will not scratch our little giraffe's legs, especially with the babies. Oh, and like I was saying, sorry, I'm just so excited. There's so much information to tell you, which is why I need more signs. We will be adding in different creatures into this giraffe exhibit as well, because it has been shown that giraffes do better in mixed species exhibits. So you'll often see them with zebras or ostriches or warthogs and other things like that, because research has shown that even if they do not directly interact with each other, giraffes do better when they are in an exhibit with other species that you might expect to see on like the open safari plains where they're from. So I thought that was really important to take note of, because that's another thing where you might never see the giraffe and the zebra interact because they just don't. But if you monitor like their hormone levels and you monitor their heart rates, they appreciate that companionship. And I think that's important. I think it means like, hey, there's other creatures here who could get eaten and not just me. That's probably what's in the giraffe's mind. But I do think that's important to keep in mind from our perspective, because often we think, hey, like these two animals aren't actually interacting. They probably don't care about each other. But then you look at it from like a body chemistry perspective, or even just a slight subtle behavioral difference perspective, and those animals actually really, really, really do care that they're next to each other, just not like on an emotional level, but some other kind of level. All right, so maybe if I put a leaf there, maybe. You know, I think what I need, I need crates! That's what I need over here. Not more piles of leaves. I think a pile of leaves somewhere over here might be appropriate, but I think I need more crates. So let's actually see. Here's the acacia wood. What if I take out my chisel, my fancy pantsy chisel, and hey, I said chisel, there we go. And then we shove our wood up there, and then voila, you can make the scaffolding, which in my mind looks just like a crate, or you can make the crates. So if we made these kinds of crates, how would it look? Not bad, not bad. I kind of like going with the acacia theme, but what would happen if I used oak wood instead? I have a little bit of oak wood. All right, let's put this away, and let's put the poppies away. Mint seeds! We can make delicious mint things! Ah, oh, that sounds so awesome. Lily, I love Tate. I love being in this world. It's just so beautiful. All right, let's do this, and then let's see. So I need to take the oak wood planks, and then how would it compare to these kinds of crates? Or I really love the scaffolding when it comes to crates. It just looks like better crates to me. And I think we're going to use those. Even though we have the acacia wood planks and they could look pretty good, I think it's too much acacia. Too much orange! And I think these look just more like natural crates that you would expect to sort of stumble on. So I think we're going to go ahead and put those there. Let's turn these back into normal wood. All right, there we go. Lily Tate. Okay, everybody's safe. We'll have to light up the outside with more termite mounds in the future too. And yeah, a few of you guys have suggested some amazing things like anteaters. I don't know if we have a model that I could like simulate anteaters with just yet, but I could try. Gosh darn it, I could definitely try. And I can't put that next to there, so what about this? And then maybe some acacia leaves over here, like in a little pile. Because I don't know about you guys, but everywhere I've ever worked usually is like all of the shelves for animal care are just overflowing with stuff, an overabundance of stuff. Maybe we'll make like another crafting station. That's probably something that would be a good idea. Like another another crafting station to go on the other side right here. And then let's see. I cut down all of the wood I needed. Okay, let's go ahead and sleep. And then we'll wrap up really quickly. I still don't have the giraffes in here, but that's okay because we'll be able to celebrate it. But yeah, you guys suggested so many cool animals. Good boy, Tate. I love feeling safe in my little like enclosed area and knowing animals and monsters can't come get me while I sleep. Oh, hopefully that's the feeling our giraffes will have when they're in here. But yeah, lots and lots of suggestions for things to drop the termite mounds. And I love the idea of adding ambient animals that will just drop random items or say random things. And eventually adding in lots of random guests that'll just be walking around that you can talk with, you could interact with. There might even be little quests that some of them will have. Bringing the zoo to life is a huge thing I want to do. And I am in contact with several people who will probably become new zoo crafters. And I'm really looking forward to what they're going to be doing as well. So that's going to be really fun. And let's go ahead and just finish up the interior, at least, of our little giraffe barn. All right. Oh, that's too tall. I can't reach the leaves. Why leaves? You're so far outside of my my reach. I get like one leaf. That's all. Two leafs. All right. Well, that's okay. I needed the wood. Lily girl, I love you. Thank you for turning around while I'm swinging the axe, my dear. All right. So let's gather these up. And what is that going to look like? So let's come in. Oh, gosh, there's a lot of little saplings. And if it was just this wood, how would it look as a fence? I think I'm going to like it. Yeah, I think I like it. Because it's a good balance to the other half of the room. And it's kind of cool. Look at the little orange piece on top. Very neat. Very neat indeed. Look at this place. Oh, I'm so proud. Oh, this is looking so awesome. Oh my gosh. All right, let's see. I need a couple more gates. I need a couple more carpenter's gates. So let's see. I need some sticks. Well, this is short tasseled bamboo. Does this count as sticks? Like, if I did that with the bamboo, would that count? Who knows? I'm going to have to figure that out. All right, so I need some more sticks to make another scaffolding. Oh, I guess I have that inside of my chest. I should just go over and get it out of the chest. Does this count as sticks? It does not. Not for this. Okay, noted. All right, let's see if I have anything inside of this chest. We've cleaned up the yard of thorns. I do. I have these at least. And a couple more sticks. We have cleaned up the yard of... And then we'll put this there. Da-da-da-da, signs. Okay, that chest is almost empty. Of thorns! We have filled it with acacia trees. I am so excited. We now have this idea for the new way that we will display information. So we can actually have real information stations that will be easy to read and interact with. Just come on up and learn all about what we need. And I will change the spelling on this. That's because I had Minecraft on the mind. But we can learn all the information we need to know about the animals we interact with and their care. It should be awesome. I am so excited. We're going to be bringing in ambient animals like little oxpeckers that can wander around and all sorts of birds that'll be here. So my goal basically is anywhere you look in our zoo, you'll be able to turn and you'll be able to see people. You'll be able to see animals. You'll be able to see ecosystems interacting with itself. It's going to be beautiful and it's going to be amazing. And it's going to be alive when we start bringing in more zoo crafters as well. All right. So let's see. I need some more sticks. Let's get more sticks. There we go. And is that going to make a gate? Not quite. All right. I only think I need like one more gate. So let's see how that does. And then this. Good job, Tate. That's exactly where this gate. Oh, I only needed one gate. All right. Whatever. Silly Siri. All right. There we go. And then come up and jump. There. Is that facing the right way? Yes, it is. Look at that. All right. And now we'll just have to remember. I'll just leave that open, I guess, that this is where the little gate is to get into that section. And then the other thing I need to do is actually make a couple spots here inside the barn where we have like little ceiling hooks, little enrichment item ceiling hooks. Where did it go? I thought I just put it. What? Why is there a hole here? There shouldn't be a hole here. Oh, gosh. I'm going to have to fix this. All right. Let's see if I can get this just right. Nope. Oh, wait. Yeah, that's just right. Okay, good. All right. So let's see. The carpenter's barrier. There it is. And then we'll come over here. Good. And then hang some leaves from it. Look at that. Oh, that's so awesome. I love it. And what we really need is like a salt block. Just somewhere. Anywhere. So block of salt. They do have salt crystals. How do you make, and there is like a compressed salt block. This salt crystal looks really cool. How do you make that? Is it just like with salt seeds? Huh. I'm going to have to figure out how to get my hands on that salt crystal because it looks really awesome. But we can just use like the salt ore if I dig it up. So at some point we need to bring like a salt ore in here and hang it from the ceiling so that the giraffes will have something to nibble on. And then I think I'm going to put another one over here. And then there's that. Oh, it's so awesome. I love it. All right. For now, I'm going to just have the leaves hanging there. I can't believe onions is used as an enrichment item too. Look at this, you guys. I kind of want to put like one more over here too. Because these are just really cute. Ah, giraffe barn. Giraffe barn, you look amazing! I'm so excited. Just imagine when our giraffes are wandering around and we have like the keepers wandering around. I wonder what we should put at the back over here. Probably more leaves for now. Because I could totally see it just being like piles of leaves everywhere. Because they eat 75 pounds of leaves a day, and that's a lot. And then, let's see. The only other things I can really think about adding would potentially be like some shelving. So if we had this, and then we were going to make shelves. I'm trying to remember. Shelf. Acacia shelf would be that. So it would be like this. All right. Hey. That's a pressure plate. There we go. Like a slab. And then I'm trying to remember. Like this? Like so? Yeah, like this. So the only other thing I can think about putting up are a whole bunch of shelves up along the wall. And then maybe a whole bunch of tools. So like a tool shelf. And I know there's a tool rack. So that's shelf. And then tool would be a tool rack. Ah, and I need iron ingot for that. All right, so I think one of the last things that we're going to do in here, other than add the actual giraffes in, is put up some shelving units and put up some tool racks and then just kind of fill those shelving units with things that I think are useful. Like maybe, saplings and things like that. And we need to think realistically about things that would be useful, like the saplings, extra jungle wood, the oak leaves. These kinds of things are useful for showing like the growth that you can encourage, like little saplings, maybe even some little dirt to represent, like we could get some dirt and put it at the bottom to represent the fact that you want to have like the acacia saplings constantly growing here. What we put inside of the chest is kind of to help with the immersive environment of showing what it would be like if this was an active giraffe barn. Here you go, Lily, have some zombie jerky. Date, there you go. Have some zombie jerky. All right. Well, we've done so much work today. Holy days. All right. Time to get a move on. I'm so excited about this. And I think next time we will go ahead and we will go snag my giraffes. I know I keep saying that. I just didn't expect to do this much work over here. It's really nice, actually. We'll go snag some salt ore if we have any inside the house. We will go snag the giraffes. We'll get a little bit of iron so that we can have some tools to work with over here. And then we will hopefully be able to breed up the giraffes. Name and breed the giraffes and have a functional giraffe pen over here. It's going to be awesome. So I'll see you guys next time. Bye-bye.